It's my pleasure to introduce Svetlana Pastukhova with a very nice talk called Improved L2 Approximations in Homogenization of Parabolic Equations with a Count of Characters. You have 25 minutes and 5 minutes for questions. You're welcome.
Thank you. First of all, I thank organizers for this conference, for invitation to make talking here. I'm very happy, really. I will speak about homogenization and more precisely about parabolic homogenization. And when we speak about parabolic equations, they naturally arise operating exponentials, semigroups. So in the talking, we will mention often these exponentials and semigroups. According to our plan, I will set the problem, discuss items in homogenization theory related to it. I must say that the large part of my talking is some overview, which prepares the listeners for the main results. They're not too simple to be formulated just now in the very beginning. I aim to formulate the new results, which are improved operator type estimates for homogenization error with remainder term of order epsilon in power 2, where epsilon is some small parameter in homogenization problem. So we begin the topic, consider a parabolic operator L epsilon depending on a small parameter epsilon, which tends to zero. The elliptic part of this operator A epsilon is divergent type, second order elliptic operator. Nabla denotes the gradient with respect to special variable X in RD.
Sorry for interrupting. У вас вот над формулой 1 прямоугольничек висит, и он черненьким нам пока кажется. Подвиньте его, пожалуйста.
I'm afraid to click on stop share. What to do?
So this rectangle appears black to us.
But I can't understand what must be done.
Его нужно подвинуть или закрыть. Вот эта штука,
but
она...
It is impossible for me.
Ну ладно, имейте тогда просто...
Вот.
Да, вот теперь он пропал.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, excellent. So we see here a divergent type second order elliptic operator, and as usual, number denotes a special gradient, and the coefficient matrix here is epsilon periodic, A epsilon. It is obtained from one periodic matrix, A of Y, when we substitute x divided by epsilon instead of y. We assume that the matrix A of y is a measurable, bounded, well-valued, one-periodic, and satisfying the conditions two with some constant positive, which is positive lambda. We will remember this constant because we will mention it very often. As usual, we assume summation over repeated indices from 1 to d. D is a special dimension everywhere. When epsilon tends to zero, the coefficients of operator epsilon are highly oscillating. Such type operators are the objects for consideration in homogenization theory. It is destined to find some homogeneous operators which can replace these complicated ones, but these homogenized operators are much more simple. We will consider the Cauchy problem with operator L epsilon in the layer RD in product with the interval 0 t capital with right side with right hand side functions f and h from the corresponding L2 space. Homogenization theory states that this problem is close in some sense to very similar problem 4, but with operator L0, which is much simpler because it is operator with constant coefficients and they can be defined via solutions to the problems on the cell of periodicity, which is unit Q. Here is the cell problem. You see equation where the role of right hand side function is played by the vector EJ from the canonical basis in RV. The boundary condition are periodic. The solution is sought in the Sobolev space of periodic function on the unit Q. And to make the uniqueness of this solution, we demand that the mean value of the periodic solution is zero. Everywhere, angle bracket denote the mean value over the unit Q. And in the bottom of the slide, you see the relations which define the homogenized matrix A0. It is the mean value of the class in from the cell equation. The first results in homogenization of various PDEs appeared in the 70s. Nowadays, there is a vast literature in homogenization, and I mention here only the first fundamental papers of 70s, that is by Bakhvalov, by the group of authors, among whom you see Zhikov, Kozlov, Olejnik, who together with Bakhvalov are one of the founders of the homogenization theory. And I mention here also fundamental monographs in homogenization theory by Vinsusan, Leons, Papanikolaou, by Bakhvalov and Panasenko, and by Zhikov, Kozlov, and Olejnik. From long ago, it is known that solution to the problems 3 and 4 are close to each other in the sense of some convergence. For example, you can consider the convergence in L2 over T section or in L2 over the layer RD in product with the interval 0 T capital. In this connection, the question arises, what is the rate of this convergence with respect to the small parameter epsilon? Or in another words, what we see according to convergence 6 or 7 that the solution to homogenized problem is some approximation to the solution of initial problem. Then what is the accuracy of this approximation with respect to the small parameter? In other words, what is the homogenization error with respect to epsilon? We must know that other norms in which the closeness of two solutions is considered may be interesting. For example, for application to diffusion theory or probability theory, Lebesgue norms L infinity and L1 norms are important. And as for convergence 7, it is pertinent to say that in the 60s, there appeared the theory of G convergence of elliptic and parabolic operators, which is due to Italian mathematician Spagnola. And this theory was further elaborated later by Zhikov, Kozlov, and Galeni. So my talking deals in some sense with the convergence of parabolic operators. From the very beginning of homogenization theory, the convergence rate estimates or homogenization error estimates with respect to the small parameter epsilon were proved by many authors. But we must say that these attempts were made under strengthened regularity assumptions on the right-hand side functions f and h, and also on the coefficients of the operator epsilon in the Cauchy problem. And I recall that in our assumptions, right-hand side functions are only from L2 spaces, and coefficients of the operator are only measurable and bounded. The great progress in this direction was made in the early of zeros. First of all, consider the Cauchy problem when the right-hand side function in the equation is zero. The homogenized problem is of the same type, and for the solution of this problem, the estimate 10 was proved. You see here the majorant in the right-hand side contains L2 normal H, Cauchy datum, and some complicated fraction containing epsilon and T, and constant C depending on the spatial dimension D and ellipticity constant lambda. We can reformulate this estimate in terms of exponential. This is the estimate 9. And this type estimates were firstly proved by Susina, assuming that coefficient matrix is symmetric. Susina used so-called operator theoretic spectral approach based on the Floquet-Block representation of periodic operators. And this approach was elaborated in the earlier publications by Biermann and Susina. I give here the main reference. And we must say that this approach by Biermann and Susina is tightly linked with self-adjoint and periodic setting. I remind you that in our problem, the matrix A is not necessarily symmetric. So the method of Biermann and Susina is not applied here. Estimate 11 was proved quietly different a little bit later in the paper by Zhikov and Pastukhova, where we applied so-called modified method of the first approximation, which is very close to the classical technique in homogenization theory. Often this method for gravity is called simply the shift method. The shift method was proposed in two versions, firstly by Zhikov, and then in our joint publications. The first version exploits the pure shift, and the second version exploits the generalized shifting, which is really smoothing. And in contrary to the method of Biermann and Susina, the shift method is not tightly linked with self-adjoint operators, with periodic setting. For example, the results which I am going to formulate now in the end are valid for locally periodic coefficients. I must say also that the first operator type estimate in homogenization were proved by Zhikov much more earlier in mid-80s. That is the estimate which you see in the top of the slide, the L infinity operator norm. And it was proved also by spectral approach, which exploits the block-in-block representation of the fundamental solution, which is the kernel of the integral operator of semigroup. And later, it was shown in our joint publication that the former Jacob's method is quite well to prove much more general result. You see here the operator estimate in LS operator norms, and here the constant depending on spatial dimension d and ellipticity constant lambda is unique for all epsilon, for all t, and for all exponents s between 1 and infinity. This is very interesting extension to my mind. But we return to estimate 10, which is equivalent to 11, and make some transformation. We raise both parts of it to the second power. So you see here in the top the result of this raising, integrate over t, and come to the central estimate. You see here L2 norm over the layer RD in product with zero t capital, and the majorant in the right hand side contain power of epsilon deteriorated by some logarithmic. It's a very peculiar feature of this estimate on the layer. Now we turn to opposite situation when in problem 3 we have zero right-hand side function in Cauchy-Dayton and right-hand side function f non-zero in the equation. Then try to seek for estimates of operator time. You see here the homogenized Cauchy problem 14, and we know that the solution to the homogenized problem due to the constancy of coefficients has the following regularity. You see the estimate in the bottom of the slide, which means that u from the space L2 on the interval O T capital with values in the space H2 over RD. And additionally, there exists spatial derivative, which is from L2 over the layer. This regularity is very important in our estimates. We can study homogenization of the problem 13 with much more general right-hand side function. But in this case, the regularity which was discussed now will not be possible. For us, it is the estimate in the bottom of the slide is very important. Now, what is the essence of the method of the modified first approximation? We use quite usual approximation for homogenization, and modification is in smoothing. We smooth the corrector. The first approximation is the sum of the zeros term, and the zeros term is smoothed solution of homogenized problem. This smoothing participates in corrector also. You see the structure of the corrector in the center of the slide. And what smoothing operator can be taken? Rather general smoothing operator having the sufficiently regular kernel. It is sufficient to take the triple of the Stiklov smoothing operator defined as follows in the bottom of this line. The Stekhov smoothing operator has the kernel of smoothing discontinuous, but the triple Stekhov smoothing operator will have the kernel of smoothing whose derivatives are Lipschitz continuous, and it is enough for our purposes. Now, the following estimates are valid, 15, 16, and they can be formulated in operator terms. For this aim, we introduce the resolving operators for initial Cauchy problem and homogenized Cauchy problem. We introduce the correcting operator K calligraphic epsilon, and we come to formulation of the estimate 15 in the form of 17. By mere coarsening, we obtain the estimate 18 or 19. But now we are aimed for approximations that have the remainder term of order epsilon in power 2. To this end, we introduce the auxiliary Cauchy problems. For example, the adjoint homogenized problem 20, where you see the operator A0 star, which is adjoint of A0. With this operator, we connect the new correcting operator K calligraphic with T the epsilon, which involves the solution of adjoint cell problems. They are denoted by tilde and G tilde. But we need also the third corrector, K without any epsilon, which is defined in formula 22. You see here the resolving operator of the homogenized Cauchy problem and some differential operator B, which has the third order. The coefficients of this operator are constant. They can be defined via the solutions to the cell problem. I don't give here the exact formula, but these are formula in terms of mean value of some periodic functions composed of the solutions to cell problems. And the main result of my talking is the estimate 23, where you see the approximation of the resolving operator of the initial Cauchy problems as the sum of resolving operator of the homogenized Cauchy problem and three correctors. The resolving operators of the Cauchy problems when the Cauchy data is zero can be expressed in terms of semigroups. I give here the formula, and we can formulate all our results in terms of semigroups. But this formulation will be rather cumbersome, so I avoid them. No, I have no time for discussion of details of proof. In conclusion, I show you the last maybe slide where I give the names of mathematicians who contributed to this direction, to this field of homogenization theory, operator type estimates. You see here the names of mathematicians from St. Petersburg, Suslina, Vasilevskaya, Mishkova, Senik, Miloslova, and there are many Chinese mathematician who are involved in this activity, Shen, Gian, Xu, Zhou, and many others. So I thank you for your attention. to my mind, I have exhausted my time.
So, yes, you've finished perfectly in time. Thank you very much. We have 5 minutes for questions. Please, questions. No questions? Okay, then I have my standard question. From your point of view, what is the most important result in your talk?
The most important result is the estimate 23, which is proved in non-self-adjoint setting. That's my answer to your question.
Thank you.
For example, the approach of our St. Petersburg colleagues is not available to them.
Are they making a talk on our conference?
What?
Are they giving a talk?
To my mind, no, they are not among the participants.
Well, actually, it is not too late to invite them. So if you are in connection with them, you can invite them, and if they hurry up, probably they can give a talk on Thursday or on Friday.
Thank you. I will send them your invitation.
Well, actually, it's conferences for everyone, so everyone can join. But if they were not very well informed, you are welcome to invite them. Also, the same I can say to everyone. If you know someone who can prepare the talk rapidly, please invite them. We will give them time in the time slot and the schedule.
Maybe some words about 23 estimate. It is seen from here that to construct the approximation of order epsilon in power 2, you should solve three homogenized problems. The standard homogenized problem and some others with different right-hand side function. They are the second part in the first term and the third part. If you look inside this formula, you see that you should solve three homogeneous problems with the same operator, but with different right-hand side functions. This will be improvement of estimation in comparison with the zeros. Well, that's all for comments.
Thank you.
Recording stopped.
The time for questions is about to finish.